Turkey, as you say, as you know, is a candidate to become a full member of the European Union. Does someone still believe that it will occur? I don't know. Even in Turkey, of course, I also believe, but no, it's just to say that everyone is a bit lazy about it, and yeah, we don't know when it will occur. Probably it will occur. It will take a time, a long time, but in an integration of a country like Turkey, even if it's possible, it takes, of course, a long time. Remember, Poland is a European, is no member of the European Union, but it was not that easy. The negotiations were very, very difficult. And of course, with another culture, another religion, another way of seeing things, and another level of revenue, it's difficult to imagine that at short term it will occur. But who knows, maybe within 10 or 15 years it will be possible. But for a short term period, it's very, very difficult to imagine that Turkey will enter the European Union.
Thank you very much for your question, Aditya, too. Gas and oil pipelines. Of course, there's a lot of interest entering in play there, and you have Eastern, Western interests, which are sometimes fighting against them, and yes, we had different projects. Some of them are concretized, some of them are concretizing now, and every 6 months there is a change. But finally, it's working because, for instance, the Kurdish petrol, the northern Iraq petrol, is coming to Turkey from Azerbaijan. We have also from Russia. In fact, Turkey is will be used as corridor, as energetic corridor, not only for oil but also for gas. And Turkey is developing now alternative energies also. The term that that was very used was long process. It was a long, long process. Of course, it's a long process. It makes 40, 50 years that Turkey is trying to enter the European Union. At the beginning, it was European Union, which was an economic community that asked the Turkey to enter. And finally, it was at the same time with Greece. And Greece entered in 1980. 1980, we had some other issues, like coup d'etat, state coup. And yeah, it changed the agenda. And now we still try to enter. But what is the question for the Europeans here is to that Turkey has to decide if it's a Western or Eastern state. I think it's quite difficult for a country to decide that if you are in a crossing between Europe and your history is linked to both parties. As well the wars, as well the economic relations, and so on, cultural relations. So it's difficult. But the main obstacle seems to be the fact that Turkey is mostly Muslim people, and here in Europe we have a Jewish-Christian tradition. With Jewish we had some trouble, I think, in Europe, but we maybe want to have good conscience to just to add the Jewish heritage in the Christian adjective. So yes, and in Germany we have people who say, okay, we have already some issues with Islam, with Turks. In France we have the same. We have also the problems. We don't know how, for instance, to manage with the veil. We can forbid it. Okay, no, but we cannot because there are human rights, and it's contrary to religion, exercise freedom. So we cannot. But
how to manage it exactly in the private, in the public sphere. It's an issue, and we don't know how to handle it. Some people seem to criticize a little bit the Turkish people here in Europe, mainly in Germany. They cannot integrate themselves quite well. The others say, okay, you say that, but I mean other European people say, but normal, it's not the problem of Turkish people, it's the problem of Germany, who cannot handle it correctly. And also, the question was asked to know if it was really interesting for Turkey. What was the interest, what was the preoccupation of Turkey? Was it really Europe or not? And according to polls, we know that formerly Turkey was very interested. It was around 70-75% of people wanted to integrate the European Union. And now the polls are not so positive in favor of Europe. It's less than 50% who want that Turkey enters in the European Union. European people think that it's better to take Turkey in his current position as a partner, as a free trade treaty, and so on. But Turkey would be Turkey interested in it? Turkey is seeking for other perspectives, like Shanghai Club, like regional powers and trades. So the question is open, but even if Turkey enters, everyone agrees that it will not be for this year. Thank you. I just want to say, in Turkey we still have issues in terms of human rights. Turkey is, sometimes it's Russia, our Russian friends, sometimes it's Turkey, but I think this time it's Turkey winning that. It's not a good award, because it's the most condemned country by Strasbourg. So everything is not pink in Turkey, everything is not going well, the minorities are not always well treated. That's true, but that's the first time that the government, and it's strange that it's a Islamic government, pro-Islamic government anyway, that has given back the rights of the minorities. I mean, not only the Kurds, but also the religious minorities, and they have given back their real estate goods. Sometimes it's in the center of Istanbul, and it's billions of dollars. No, even left-winged governments never intended to give that. Never. And it's the first time it is given. The current government sometimes is, in terms of communication, it's not really, very diplomatic. But Erdogan says, I'm not a diplomat, I'm a politician. So, and the fact that he's acting like this in terms of votes is helping him. So he has strategies, and yeah. Finally, it's foreseen that Turkey will have 5.2% till 2023 in terms of economy. As a GDP progress, and I think we can do something with Turkey. An economy that goes well. I'm not Marxist, but Marx used to say the infrastructure is determining. Sometimes the communism is something I don't share, but sometimes you have good phrases in some doctrines. And I think that's not always true, but when you consider that human rights is important, you don't have to forget that economical welfare is important. If you don't eat if you are starved, you cannot think about human rights. The economy growing, I'm sure, it will help the human rights in Turkey. And the last 10, 12 years, that's what happened. That's what happened. I thank you very much for your patience.